In a few days' time, guys, it's going to be Armistice Day. That's a day where we remember all the men and women, regardless of their skin colour, who sacrificed so much in World War II and all the wars as well. But we're talking about World War II specifically in this video. And without their sacrifice, most of us just simply would not be here now. And that's a fact. Now, before I get into the hows and the whys and the do you mind if I don't? Yes, Blackadder. I just want to say something. The fact that we are having this discussion at all is just horrible. I mean, I got a video sent to me by one of my subscribers just yesterday. Now, I've seen this video a lot of times myself, but it reminded me of the absurdity of all of this race baiting, because that's what a lot of it is that we see in society today. I don't even see skin colour. And I, do you know what? I don't think many other people saw skin colour until the last few years where it's been rammed down our throats. And Morgan Freeman summed it up, and this guy sent me this video, and I'm going to play you a little clip, because this sums it up for me. I 100% agree with what Morgan Freeman says here about the whole race thing.
Black History Month, you find
ridiculous.
Why?
You're going to relegate my history to a month?
Oh, come on.
What do you do with yours? Which month is White History Month? Come on, tell me.
I'm Jewish.
Okay, which month is Jewish History Month?
There isn't one.
Oh, why not?
Yeah.
You want one?
No.
I don't either. I don't want a Black History Month. Black history is American history.
How are we going to get rid of racism?
Stop talking about it.
So anyway, guys, I'm going to talk about the way the Activision, the developers, handled this in Call of Duty Vanguard, which I thought was just horrible, the way that they did it. I don't want to waffle on, so I'll get straight to the point. I'm going to talk about Operation Tonga, which was a huge operation behind enemy lines hours before the D-Day landings took place. They were dropping a lot of paratroopers behind enemy lines in gliders and whatnot, and their mission was crucial. They had to capture and destroy certain bridges leading to the beaches of Normandy and also take out long-range artillery. If they hadn't done that, D-Day would have been a failure, because the Germans would have been able to reinforce the beachhead by using the bridges, and they would have also had access to long-range artillery, which would have absolutely massacred people on the beaches and even hit the ships, because it had such a long range. So it was important that these paras took these things out, and they did. They did, and it was a massive success, but they lost massive casualties. A lot of them died, most of them died. And they will have known this when they were given the orders. I mean, you know, when there's a battalion of you are going to go behind enemy lines in among shit tons of Germans, and you're going to attack the Germans, you're probably not coming home. And they'll have known that. But they still, you know, let's do it. They had to do it because, look, their country was at stake here. Like, they couldn't fail, you know. And so this is portrayed in the game. And you play as a guy called Arthur Kingsley, who was the first, he's based on a real character called Sidney Cannell, who was the first black paratrooper. And he was actually one of the people who was dropped behind enemy lines, IRL, during World War II. So that's great that you get to play him. Unfortunately, everything he did in real life, you don't do any of that in the game. He actually steals the identity of a guy called Lieutenant Colonel Terence Otway. It's kind of weird because Lieutenant Colonel Terence Otway is in the game as well. He's Richard Webb. He's the proof of that.
Richard Webb is inspired by Terence Otway. Otway was an officer commanding the 9th Parachute Battalion.
We took a lot of inspiration on our Operation Tonga level in the game, and Richard Webb was a big part of that.
So how can you do his job if he was there and he's in the game and didn't do what he's supposed to have done in real life, but you do it as Arthur Kingsley? What's going on? Well, let me educate you. The real Operation Tonga is very similar to the one in the game. In fact, all the actions that you do in the game happened in real life. You have a firefight at a farmhouse, and it's at the farmhouse when you killed the Germans that people start rendezvousing there. But it was such a botched landing. Gliders were shot down, people landed in the wrong place, and so only half of the troops that they had actually made it to the rendezvous point, and none of them were sappers, and they only had one deployable machine gun. So they were understaffed, to say the least. Now in the game, when Kingsley gets there, he finds the paratroopers all dejected, and they are refusing to go on and do the mission because they're scared of dying.
Nice to see you, gents. Where do we stand?
The captain didn't make it, so we're on our own now. I say we dig in and wait for the rest of the Sixth Airborne to assemble.
Henry said we have till dawn to destroy the artillery. If we don't, the invasion fails.
So you fancy yourself the captain now?
Sunup's an hour away at best. There's no time for a sit-down.
Yeah, there's also no muscle and no cavalry coming to save the bloody day. The only thing we can do here is to die or try not to.
How f***ing disrespectful to these people who, under half strength, actually went and charged against these Germans and lost half of their soldiers. They had none of the gear that they were supposed to have, but I'll read you the account. This is what really happened. Otway arrived at the drop zone at 1:30 a.m. By 2:35, only 110 paratroopers had assembled, with only a single machine gun and a small number of Bangalore torpedoes. This was a significant setback for the battalion, as the plan to assault the artillery battery relied on having the entire battalion present and a number of sappers, as well as a large quantity of heavy equipment. But under strict orders that the battery had to be destroyed no later than 5:30 a.m, Otway felt that he could no longer wait for any more men to arrive, and he just set off regardless with his 150 paratroopers. Long story short, they charged into the guns, 50 of them were killed, 25 of them were wounded. And they then, after destroying the guns and accomplishing their task, they went and attacked a village down the road which had a platoon of Germans in it, drove them out, and then managed to hold out in the village. So, absolute f***ing heroes, the lot of them. But they're portrayed in the game as cowards until Kingsley arrives and rallies them and says, you've got to do this, you've got to do this. And then Kingsley takes all the glory for doing what Terence Otway did. How f***ing disgusting and disrespectful is that to not only Sidney Cannell, but also to Terence Otway? And it's going to get worse, guys, because now I'm going to tell you about Sidney Cannell, the first black paratrooper, and what he actually did in World War II. Get your popcorn out, you're going to love this. I'm reading this from the paratroopers' data records. Okay, so this isn't from some woke site, this is the actual paratroopers' site. This soldier was one of the parachutists who landed behind the German lines in Normandy on the night of the 5th-6th of June 1944. During the next 5 weeks, he was in almost continuous action of the most trying and difficult nature. He was a company runner and had repeatedly carried messages through the most heavy and accurate mortar and machine gun fire. 4 times wounded in action, this soldier had never been evacuated and carried on with his job cheerfully and efficiently, with many acts of gallantry. Very many acts of gallantry have been performed by members of the battalion, but for sustained courage, nothing surpasses Cannell's effort. His courage and many wounds have made him a well-known and admired character throughout not only his own battalion, but his whole brigade. Now I'm going to read one specific thing that he did. This is just insane. On the 18th of June 1944, his company carried out a raid on a strong enemy position in the Bois de Bavent area. Whatever, I'll probably butcher that name, but it's French. The position was stronger than expected, and the company was hard-pressed and the wireless set destroyed. Cannell was sent back with a verbal message. He was wounded during the journey, but carried on and delivered his message correctly, and then set off with a reply. He was wounded a second time on his return journey, but again carried on and again delivered the message correctly. During the remainder of the raid, despite his 2 wounds, he was outstanding for his courage and dash. The courage and devotion to duty displayed by Cannell on this one occasion was an inspiration to all who witnessed it. He has performed similar runs on countless occasions, and as has been pointing out before, has been wounded twice more, but this is still a runner of his company and is as cheerful as before. Sadly, he died in 1945. Guess what he was doing? Charging across a bridge that he knew was primed with explosives towards the Germans at the other side of the bridge who had the plunger. And there was a whole load of Paras charged this bridge to try and seize it before the Germans blew it up. Unfortunately, as they were charging across, the Germans blew it up. A lot of Paras made it, and they did kill the Germans and seize what was left of the bridge. But Sidney Cannell was one of the ones that got blown up. There was 33 of them got blown up, and he was one of them. So he died doing a very heroic act. So this is a guy who's portrayed in Call of Duty Vanguard, and he's done all these amazing things, and you do none of these things in the game. It appears that what he did in real life was just wasn't good enough for the game, I'm afraid. They had to make him do something that he didn't do. Not only is that disrespectful completely to Sidney Cannell, but it's disrespectful, as I said, to Otway. I mean, this is what pisses me off when I play these games, because why didn't you just... You had a great opportunity here to bring these two characters to life, both of them brave heroes, and you could have just let them do what they actually did. And you could have used that and said, hey, look, you play this guy and you're going to do exactly what he did during the war. But instead, no, let's just disrespect the whole fucking... absolutely disgraceful. A week away from Armistice Day as well. Fuck off, please. I could go on about the 93rd, the all-black regiment who saved an American and a Mexican from the Japanese, and then pretty much racially abuse them as soon as they rescue them, which I was just jaw-dropped at. I was just like, what the... That would just not have happened. Why put it in? Why do that? Do you know, why do that? You know, calling them white boy and all that. That's not how they'll have gone on. Do you know what I mean? It's just... Yes, that was said back then. So was a lot of things, but it's in this, it's portrayed as, oh, that's just normal. That's just the way it was. No, it wasn't. I've read a lot of history on that. Do you know what? There was black regiments in the Civil War. Amazing movie, Glory, if you haven't seen it. Well worth watching. Fabulous, fabulous movie. You know, people respected each other. They were all fighting on the same side. People had the utmost respect because they were fighting for their lives on a daily basis. They weren't going around just dissing each other. Yes, there was banter. There was banter between the British and the Australians, but that's all it was. We fought side by side with the Australians in countless conflicts and battles. We trained together. Our SAS are pretty much joined at the hip. We have the utmost respect for each other in combat, but this game portrays it as absolute garbage. I think it's like everything, isn't it, these days? Banter is kind of like construed as hatred. It's just not. So at the end of the day, as much as this is a fictional story, it uses real missions that actually happened, and it's based off real people that in most cases were actually there. And I think that when you're going to go that far, you should have the decency and the respect to value what they actually did there, instead of changing it, or in the worst case, like they did in this, give all the glory to somebody who wasn't even there, purely because it fits their particular narrative. That's very, very disingenuous to the people who fought and in many cases died there. So that's what I wanted to say. It's happening far too often now in games, and it just needs to stop, because people who maybe don't know the history, they could play this game and be forgiven for thinking that this kind of stuff's real because of a simple Google saying, hang on, was Operation Tonga real? Yeah, it was. All right. Oh, they did the Guns of Merville. This is what must have happened then, when it just didn't.